Hey everybody, Luke from Guy Reviews here. Today we're going to be taking a look at the ADT command system. This is their most advanced home-based security system. It has a lot of features built into it, and it really relies heavily on being able to control it from the internet, home automation, things like when you come home, having it automatically turn up the temp and more in the home. Now, this is the next generation from the ADT Pulse, which you probably have heard a lot about if you ever had ADT in the last few years. That was kind of their first generation effort into home automation, home security through being able to control it from your phones, using a smart device like a Echo to control your home security. This takes all that, ramps it up to the next level, gives you a really nice touchscreen interface here I'll talk about, and the ability to control it from multiple different devices. So we're going to talk about this from the main control panel, the secondary ones, which you can mount on a wall or have as a tablet, and from the mobile devices. So keep that in mind. If you're looking for sensors, they have a wide range. Of course, many homes nowadays come pre-wired, but of course you can get wireless sensors for your doors and windows, glass break, fire, smoke, carbon monoxide detectors, motion sensors, and more with it. Real quick before we break this all down, if you're new here, do me a huge favor, hit the subscribe button, hit the thumbs up. It really does help us because it lets YouTube know you enjoy what we do here. Now, this is the main control panel here. This is the main system. A couple cool new features compared to the older ADT systems is it's a touch panel. Very nice, responsive touch panel. This can dim. Now, I have it set to always on for this review, but you can set it to dim after 2 minutes, after 10 minutes, etc., which is really nice if you have one in your bedroom right next to the bed, for example. Now, with that, you do have to kind of strike it twice, kind of real hard, not quite as receptive as maybe an Android or iOS device. Past that, very nice user interface here. Of course, you got the ready to arm for away right there. Stay custom, which I like a lot. I love leaving the windows open sometimes, but with custom, I can say, hey, turn on the glass break, turn on the motion sensor. So if somebody comes into the home, I can still detect that. It also has the ability for automation to set it up to link to smart thermostats, lights, and more. So maybe when you disarm the security system from your phone, it turns on the lights in your home and other features. Of course, you also have the ability here to request fire, police, personal, and more. One of the cool features of the new command center is it has a cell phone built into it. Before, they used to have a separate device you'd have to plug into where all the wires come in. This has both Wi-Fi and cell phone service here. So no more needing a home phone service. No more having to worry about power outage, maybe losing it. This can still connect to the system through that. I love that it's Wi-Fi 2, ADT Pulse, at least the system I had didn't work with Wi-Fi. You had to run an Ethernet cable to your modem. Now, the tough part about that is what happens if your modem's not conveniently located next to your security panel? That was an annoyance of it. This will connect to your Wi-Fi system for Wi-Fi control there, and of course has the backup cellular connection, which is really nice. Because of that, it will also allow you to talk directly to ADT through this. So if there is a fire or more happening, there is a microphone in this. It can communicate directly to ADT through there. If you, for instance, come in here and click on medical, police, or fire, they can say, hey, what's happening, and get you help that way, which is really nice. Also, something that ADT did in the past was allow you to have multiple codes, so your kids could have a code, and you could track when they're coming and going. That way you know if they're not home when they should be. It also has now a camera, which you can disable, but it will take a picture of people coming and going. I live with a lot of family. They all have the code. So if I'm gone and somebody's coming in to the house for something, it is kind of nice to be able to say, oh, hey, my parents came into the home, or have an idea of who that was. So instead of needing to give everybody different codes, you could have a couple codes and get a picture of that person coming and going. So you know, hey, you know, why is my daughter's best friend coming into the home using the security system to disable it? Did my daughter give her the code? That kind of situation. So that's kind of cool. It is really easy to set. You just hit the, for instance, the arm away, and you enter the code. Now, one thing I wish they did here was a silent entry. On the mobile device, you can say silent, so you don't get that voiceover that says, hey, arming now, for example. It still will beep when you arm it, but I like that, especially if you have one in the master bedroom, if I'm leaving early for work, my wife's still in bed. I don't want it blaring, system disarmed in the bedroom when she's trying to sleep at 3 o'clock and I'm on my way to the airport, for example. So that's a pretty cool feature there. Of course, you can break down all the zones, you can set up automation. There's even help videos on here where you can watch a video if you have a question about it, which is pretty cool. I really like the fact that they combine the cell phone features, the Wi-Fi, all that into this. And it's a very nice, it looks nice, and it works well. So two thumbs up on this particular control panel. Now the downside to the system comes with the other control panels. I don't know if you're like me, my last home actually had three. One by the garage door, one by the front door, and one in the master. One quick note about this before we jump over to the master. The one thing I kind of don't like about this is on the old system, if for instance I'm in the master, somebody's breaking in, I could just hit a button and boom, police are coming. Here it's a couple extra steps to get to that. Not a huge amount, but I kind of wish there was a quicker panic button system on this. So keep that in mind. Though with cell phones, I think a lot of people may be going away from having a panel put in their bedroom. We had it all wired there, instead of leaving the old company's one, we decided to put it there. It is kind of nice just to lean over and tap the disarm arm, all that, without needing to get your phone and more. So let's go jump over to the bedroom, look at the second panel real quick. All right, now we're in my bedroom with this second control panel here. Now this is the downside to the command system. There is only one main command system like you saw back there with the speaker built into it and more. The second panels are like a tablet. This is actual a tablet here that can be removed from this and you can carry it around. It has a little micro USB port there to charge it and even a power thing right here to turn it on and off, which is kind of cool. The downside to it is because it's a tablet, it goes into a stand on the wall, which can be powered through the old cable for your old security system, but it leaves a big gap of air here. Now the problem there is, you can see, like I got this old wallpaper that used to be in the home from a previous owner, and it's got the even little plastic covers here for where the screws went in to hold the old control system. So you're probably going to find yourself having to do a little touch up here. But the good news is this can actually be removed. There's a little screw in the bottom. You can do it. You can take it off. We're going to remove that wallpaper and paint it again. So keep that in mind. You're probably going to be finding yourself having to do some touch up painting here instead of having to go through and have it all covered by the old control panel. A lot of the ADT systems before, when I replaced ADT from another system, it covered all that damage from the old control panel. So keep that in mind. According to the installer, there are only one main control panels like the one I just showed you. All the others are what you see here. And if that is an issue for you, keep that in mind. All right, let me move the camera real quick and show you the actual screen on this tablet and we can talk about it. All right, this is the second control panel. This is what all the other ones will look like. Now it is a tablet. There's even a stand built into the back of it. So you can set it up on your nightstand if you don't want it on the wall, or you can carry it around, which is nice if you're using maybe their security cameras and you want to view them. Now, past that, everything else is the same. You do see a little different form factor with the camera here on the side and more, but it is battery powered, which is nice, can be charged through the old wires on the control panel and more. Now, when I first had the system installed, the guy was telling me, oh, no, don't have a stand for it. We'll just give you, put it on your nightstand. And he tried to leave the old control system from the previous security system. I called and then they came back and set me up with an actual stand on it, which is nice. But again, talking about the sticking out from the wall there. So question is, how would you want it? Does it matter? You have a phone. I like this being here still. I don't want to rely on my phone, rely on the internet working, rely on the cellular service. So keep that in mind. I like having a dedicated system. This is connected directly into the control panels here, which is nice. Past that, all the controls are the same on it. So if you use the one before, you're going to be right at home with this new system here from ADT on the control panels. All right, let me jump over to the phone app and let's talk about the phone app and then talk about my thoughts on ADT overall. All right, this is the phone app. I'm gonna try to hold this. Sorry if the quality is not the greatest. It is very similar to the older ADT Pulse, but it is a lot more cleaned up, a lot more beautiful, easier to use. This is the main screen when we first load into it. Of course, you got the ability to see the history here so you can see everything happening. You can filter this by all kinds of different settings if you want. You do have the scenes down here where you can come in here and see the weather and edit your home screen and put different things on the screen and more. So you can have different information centers there if you want. Customize it however you want. Let's go over into the settings. A couple of cool features is geo services. For instance, I have it set up so once I leave my home, go more than a mile from it, it will remind me to set the security system if it's not set. You can also go in here and manage your users, login information, app settings, and you can even go in here and add devices for different things like smart home and more. So it's a pretty cool, easy to use app. You can set it up many different ways, require login every time or not, use your phone's own smart login for face and all that kind of stuff with it, which I really like. You can also go right in here and see what's new in your system, get support from the app and more. So I would say that maybe the biggest improvement in the command center versus ADT Pulse is the app. It's just so simple and easy to use, a lot less clutter. With the ADT Pulse app, I noticed it was a lot slower when I logged in. So when I would log in, click on an app to disarm, wasn't nearly as responsive. The command seems to take the responsiveness a lot farther. I had SimpleSafe at my old company office that we used, and that was okay, but I would say the mobile app on this is far better, much smoother, easier to use, nicer looking control panels and more. So overall, I would say this is very easy. There's really not a lot to it. Really, I would never mess with any of this. Once I get in here and set up the users for my daughter, or maybe a guest password for when we want to have somebody come in, which is really nice. You can set it up so, hey, on this day at this time, this password will work. For instance, if you have somebody coming to clean your home, just one time, you can give them the code, and that one time it works. And then the next day, if they try to do it, it won't disarm the system for them. So really cool features there ADT added. Overall, I'm gonna give ADT 2 thumbs up on this. It's a nice system. It's not the cheapest system, but I will say the quality of the system is very good. The sensors work well, the app is excellent, the control panels are very nice. My only real complaint is the alternate panels. I know a lot of people have multiple panels in their home. Like I said, by the garage door, front door, maybe in your master. Having that one that kind of sticks out like that is kind of annoying. So keep that in mind that if you have an older system, you may need to get a painter to come or get paint it yourself to touch up the area behind the other control panels. Other than that, it's excellent. So if you have any questions, please let me know. Do me a favor. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. It really does help us. Also, hit the subscribe button. It really lets YouTube know you like what we do here. Check us back for our weekly news shows, reviews, and how-to guides like this one. Thanks for your support. We'll be back next week with even more videos. And as always, take care, everybody.